Off the glass, looks for Calvert. Clutterbuck had it briefly, unable to keep it in the offensive zone. And it chopped back in. Russell. Almost picked off there by Cullen. Here's Reve stepping away from the forecheck. Retreats, then rings it around the wall for Calvert, who is unable to handle it again. Here, Clutterbuck. Off his skate, Cullen cycles. Clutterbuck knocked down by Reve up high. It's sent to Scandella. Scandella wrists it wide of the net. Reve is hit there by Clutterbuck. Fights off the hit, and the jacket's clear. Reve wanting a piece of Clutterbuck, who continues into his own zone and now off to the bench.
And that's why he leads the National Hockey League in hits.
Here, a shot by Nash, and he scores! Well, so much for the goalless drought. This afternoon here in Minnesota, Rick Nash pulls the trigger, beats Backstrom, and the Jackets have the all-important 1-0 lead.
Well, when it doesn't come natural, you've got to have some help from others to help manufacture your goals. But look at where Rick Nash gets a hold of that puck in that slot area, and he has got nothing but the goaltender in the net, finds a little space on the low glove, and the Jackets have taken a 1-0 lead. Oh, is that long due for number 61?
It is goal number 30. If you recall several games ago, Nash thought he had number 30, only to see the goal change to Derek McKenzie, and rightfully so, as McKenzie swept it across the goal line. But now, officially, number 30 is in. But more importantly, the Jackets have a 1-0 lead.
Remember as well, when Rick Nash scores, streaks do begin, and it's exactly number 61 would like right now to be able to get back on his high horse with the number of games remaining, be able to try to lead this team. We talk about shifts, we talk about games, this is a great start for this hockey team.